Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to do quick tips for editing inside of Camtasia, some of the things that I do to speed up my editing. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts. You can also see templates and download templates for Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI and video templates, including an interactive video template, and then some courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Score, and HTML5 video. So I have a project already pulled up in Camtasia. So I'm going to go ahead and double click on it. And you can see here, as I start to scroll through, this is just a simple screen recording. And the first thing I want to show you as far as a quick tip in your editing, and this is something that I do all the time, is sometimes you'll have to edit the video without the audio. So I always split my audio and video. So I'm going to right click here and go to separate video and audio. That way I can take care of the video, extend it out if needed, and I can work with those separately without having them be one file, basically. Now, the first thing I wanna do is I sometimes pause in my video, especially if something's loading. And so I wanna get rid of that so the learner is not just sitting there and watching that big pause. The way that you do that quickly, I mean, you could come up here and you can hit Command Shift T if you're on a Mac, or Control Shift, and I think it might be P or T on Windows. If you go ahead and do that, it'll split both the audio and the video at the same time. Or if you have one selected and hit Command T, it'll just split that one. So those are some shortcuts that you may want to use frequently. However, if you just hold down Control, or if you hold down Command and click and drag an entire area that you want to delete, and then holding the Command button or the Control button down still, go ahead and hit the Delete button. That will take that and it will make it shorter. And that is how I get rid of those big spaces, basically. And so I can come in here and just hit Control or Command Delete. And I also zoom in on my timeline and zoom out on my timeline by holding the Control button down or the Command button on a Mac, and then using my cursor on my mouse to scroll in or scroll out. So you can see here, scroll in, scroll out, and that's how I can get really into the timeline to fine tune certain parts and then scroll out to see the picture as a whole, basically. I use that all the time, basically. It's a really nice feature. All right, so as you start to come in here, another thing that's common is sometimes I'm going to scroll down kind of to the end here. And notice that I start to, not in that part, but I'm going to come over here. So you can see that I start to type out my text here. But it takes a while, so you can actually speed that up if you cut everything. So Shift Command and then T, or Shift Control and then T or P again on Windows. And then take it to the end here. I'm not the fastest typer in the world, so I like to just cut those two parts here, and I'm going to speed that up. So I'm going to right click in here and go to add to clip speed, and then just go ahead and make that a 2. And so it's still kind of readable. It doesn't go extremely fast, but the learner doesn't have to sit there and watch me type very slowly. There's also a couple other things here. You notice that I start to move my cursor down. If I'm going to edit this part out, for example, this big pause, well, I don't want to edit out that all of a sudden it jumped down to the bottom of the screen here. So I'm going to, if I come in here, I'm going to split that out, and I want to keep this part where I scroll down. But I want that part to happen as soon as the audio basically starts there. So what I can do is keep that part that's scrolling, but I'm going to, just with the video selected, I'm going to hit Command T again, and I'm going to split out or just take out that first part there and move this to right when the audio starts. So as soon as the audio starts, it's going to scroll down. So I still have that, but now I have this big gap that is just, if I hit play, it's going to be black. Well, it can take a frame and I can extend it out, and so therefore nothing really happens. It's almost like a freeze frame. And I can do this easily inside of Camtasia here. So if I go ahead and I hold down the Alt button or the Option button on a Mac, and I think the Alt button on a PC, and I hover over the edge of either edge actually really works, but I hover over the edge that I want to, you know, freeze frame, I can just click and I can drag. And you can see that there's a little stitch there, but now it just freezes everything and then it moves on after that. So it's a way for me to be able to kind of fix that and move that and shift it. And so now I can come into here and I can just hold down the command or control and I can delete out that part and now it's a little bit more seamless there. So I do that all the time, especially if I'm like switching screens or a little pop-up alert happens, then I will use the freeze frame to cut out that pop-up and then basically extend out the part before that happened. And so it's pretty seamless at that point. Another thing that I do is I use the callouts all the time. And if I come into the visual effects, this masking I use all the time if I want to highlight something on the screen. So let's say I want to highlight something. Notice how it blacks out everything. I don't exactly want it to black out. So I can change the opacity in the mask settings with this selected. I can change the opacity as needed. But a problem that I have is it applies it to the entire rest of the video. I don't want that to happen. So I'm going to hit Command Z, come back to here, and I only want the mask to happen to this point. So I'm going to hit Command or Control T, and I just want the mask to happen at this point of the video. Now I can drag that mask out here, and then I can adjust the opacity so it's not as, it doesn't black out everything there. And I'm going to move this circle, not everything, but I'm just going to move this circle over to here. Let's say I wanted to focus on the date. It doesn't have to be a circle. You can actually have this be a rectangle, and then you can adjust the rectangle as needed. So if I just kind of adjust it here, so it's just focused on the date, I can do that as well. Now this automatically happens as soon as I get to this video. It's just going to automatically happen. If I want this to fade in, I can use the easing to add 1 second to the easing in. So it's going to fade in and then it's going to fade out. So you can see it fades in and then it fades out. Now you can see I scrolled down at this point. So I may actually want to split there and then get rid. If I click on this little arrow button, this is where I can see the mask. Get rid of the arrow there or the mask there. And you can see now it'll fade in at that point and fade out. Actually, I may need to modify this because I split it. You can see that it wasn't exactly perfect there. So I had to add the fade back in because I cut that out before here. So, all right. So that's how I use that masking all the time. And then if you wanted to zoom in on different parts, you can also use an animation. So if I come into animation and do custom, what happens is, let's say I wanted to zoom into this part where my mouse is right here. Well, I just click on this endpoint. So when you're doing animations, you have a point A and you have a point B. What it's going to look like at point A when it first starts and what it's going to look like at point B. And then you adjust the properties that need to change. So in this case, we would adjust the zoom. We want to zoom in at different parts and the position as well. So all you have to do is click on point B. I call it point B. But you click on that endpoint here and then you adjust the scale and then just kind of move it down into place. I wouldn't move it so the bottom half of your video is kind of lost there. So just kind of move it down to where you think. And now you can see that's how it adds the animation. Let's say we need to zoom back out after that's done. Well, I can just quickly add a custom animation again. And then instead of having to go to 100% here, I can just click on this arrow kind of reset. And now, well, actually that part didn't work, but let me go into just kind of stretch this out to fit. So now it will zoom in and then it will zoom out. You could even, instead of zooming out, you can just move it to a different section as well. I would avoid doing too many because it could disorient the learner and they're just, okay, where am I now? But if you wanted to zoom in and focus on a certain part for a little while and zoom out, you can do that as well. So those are some of the quick tips and common editing things that I do when I'm working with Camtasia videos. Hopefully those were useful for you. Let me know in the comments what else you want to see in Camtasia. Is there anything else you're trying to do that I can help you with? And comment below. And if you like this video, go ahead to my YouTube channel and click on like and subscribe and click that bell icon so you get notified whenever I release a new video. You can also check out my website if you go to learningdojo.ninja. This is where you can check out all previous blog posts, templates on Storyline and XAPI and video templates. And then you can also check out full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. Camtasia is a tool I use all the time, so I wanted to share these quick tips and show you how easy it is to actually do some of the stuff when you're recording and editing videos. If you want to see more, just come back. I release a new video each week, and I'll see you next time.